In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always. As we continue the Easter season, we're in the sixth Sunday already. It may seem like a long season because of our circumstances this year, but it's a joyful season, a season of hope. And one of our readings today invites us to always be ready to provide the reason for our hope. That reason is Jesus Christ and our faith in him, who promises to be with us always and not leave us orphaned. Thank you for returning to be with us today. I know we had some significant sound difficulties last week, and we hope and pray that your participation through the video technology today will be much better and easier so that we forget about the technology and focus on the Lord in our connection with one another. Let us call to mind the ways that we have loved God and one another, but also the ways that we have sinned in failing to love, asking God's mercy and forgiveness so that we may more worthily celebrate these sacred mysteries.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Let us listen to God's holy word.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed the Christ to them. With one accord, the crowds paid attention to what was said by Philip when they heard it and saw the signs he was doing. For unclean spirits, crying out in a loud voice, came out of many possessed people, and many paralyzed or crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. Now when the apostles in Jerusalem heard that Samaria had accepted the word of God, they sent them Peter and John, who went down and prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Spirit. For it had not yet fallen upon any of them. They had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then they laid hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, sanctify Christ as Lord in your hearts. Always be ready to give an explanation to anyone who asks you for a reason for your hope, but do it with gentleness and reverence, keeping your conscience clear, so that when you are maligned for those who defame your good conduct in Christ may themselves be put to shame. For it is better to suffer for doing good, if that be the will of God, than for doing evil. For Christ also suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Lord be with you.
Your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments." One gospel. Jesus said to his disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you always, the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot accept, because it neither sees nor knows him. But you know him, because he remains with you and will be with you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me because I live, and you will live. On that day, you will realize that I am in the Father, and you are in me, and I in you. Whoever has my commandments and observes them is the one who loves me. And whoever loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and reveal myself to him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today in the Acts of the Apostles, Philip is in Samaria, and there's a lot of joy. The joy that St. Peter refers to, the joy of the hope that we hold in our hearts. Because of that good news, the good news of the risen Lord, and the things that the disciples were doing. And they waited for the Spirit. They waited for John to come down, John and Paul to come and lay hands on them, just as we await Pentecost in a couple of weeks. About a year ago, I was in Samaria. And that's the place probably more known for the place where Jesus spoke to the woman at the well. And it's a ride from Jerusalem up to Samaria. And we were thirsty when we arrived there, just as Jesus was after his travels. But there was a lot of excitement that day as we made our way to the basement of the church where the well was. And when we got there, there was the windlass, the crank with the rope and a bucket tied to it. And the people started to lower the bucket into the well to fetch some water. And there was a lot of excitement. So much excitement that the second group that came to get some water, they hastily lowered the bucket, and we thought that the rope was going to break and we wouldn't get a drink. But we did. But like the woman that Jesus spoke to, no, we were thirsty after that. Besides Jesus' physical thirst that day, his thirst was to save us because of his love for us. You know, we all get caught up in things of the world, and up until a few months ago, that was work and play and socializing. But even now, maybe, you know, some of us are getting weary by what's come into our lives. Because we had plenty of water, plenty of that plain water to drink, but it seems that that's dried up a little bit. You know, our lives aren't just about things of the earth. St. Peter reminds us, Christ suffered for us, for our sins, so that he might lead us to God. And he was put to death in the flesh, just like we'll die someday. But he was brought to life in the spirit which we await. Our Lord teaches and he reveals to us in the gospel today who God is in the Holy Spirit, in the Holy Trinity, in the special gift of the Holy Spirit that's given to us by the Father and the Son. The apostles learned, and they were taught by Jesus, that first advocate. And then they were reminded and guided by the Spirit of Truth, the second advocate. And for them in a very special way, as they were to guide the church. But we too, we've received that Spirit, and we share in the life of Jesus. And more than that, what Jesus says today is that he lives in the Father, and so we are also living in God as we live in him, in the Spirit, through that Holy Trinity. We actually share in God's life here, the kingdom of God that Jesus revealed, brought to us, and we best experience it when we can be at Mass on Sundays or during the week. But we're called to reveal it, nevertheless, and in the end, when Jesus comes the second time, he will reveal it and we will experience it in its fullest. Jesus says we will love him if we keep his commandments. What is his commandment? Jesus said he didn't come to abolish any of the laws or the prophets, but to fulfill all of them. And so it's not a new commandment, because the commandment is to love God with all our heart and to love our neighbor as ourselves. St. John refers to God, or says God is love. We know that the Father loves us because Jesus told us, and we and everything visible and invisible exist because of that love. It's even true for people who don't follow God or know him. You know, we have free will to accept or reject his love. But of course, he wants everyone to know him, and that has become our mission in Christ, to help others come to know him. Jesus' commandment is to love as he loves. Jesus shows us how to live our humanity to the fullest, and then with the help of the Holy Spirit and his grace, we can fulfill that. Jesus' love is a self-giving love, even to death. And Jesus followed the will of the Father, accepting his passion and death out of love for the Father and out of love for us. We wouldn't have Easter or resurrection if that weren't the case. That's why St. Peter reminds us that if God wills it, you know, if he allows something to happen that might be bad or that might be difficult in our lives, the suffering, like Jesus' own suffering, can lead to good that we don't know or that we don't expect. The Spirit that we receive is that living water. It gives us life, a life called to love. It's a share in the love of Jesus and the Father that's manifested in the Holy Spirit. And we have many examples of that love, that self-giving love in our lives all the time. As the bridegroom of the church, Jesus gave himself up for us. Priests and religious, they dedicate their lives to service to God and to the church, to us. Married couples, they give their lives to each other, and they give their lives to their children, whether they're adopted or natural children. So we've always seen people doing these things in our lives. But even now, in this difficult time of quarantine, there's many examples of self-giving love that's a sign of the Spirit of Christ, you know, guiding us in his love and people sharing that with others. And some of these things you may be aware of and maybe some not. There's so many people that have stepped up. You see it all the time, making masks. It's like a contest of who could make the fancy mask or the new and improved mask. You've seen companies retooling to make masks, to make ventilators, all these examples of great American ingenuity. There's National Guardsmen and Guardswomen that are building hospitals or have built hospitals here and in other states, and some of them remaining away from their families for weeks. Parents, always the first teachers of their children, but now in even a more challenging way to help with that responsibility of supporting them with elementary and even high school classes. And there's the anxiety that the first responders and healthcare workers face, comforting those who can't receive visitors while still caring for their health. And priests who recently are again able to anoint the sick, as they've always done, but now especially those with COVID-19. But close to home, parishioners reached out to folks that don't have internet. They reached out by phone, checking in and letting them know that we're praying for them and You know, even though we can't be together, we're thinking of them. We ask them if they have any needs that we can help them with. And all of you praying at home for us and with us are a great blessing and a great joy to us. The Knights of Columbus in the parishes are helping with the grounds, cleaning the churches, and launching a new program to offer shopping to those who are afraid to go out to the supermarkets or can't get there, and offering home delivery to those in our communities. And you know, Father said, we're working really hard to try to give you a very high quality live streaming at the Sunday Masses. And all of that does involve a lot of people's time and talents among all the other responsibilities that people are trying to execute. And all of us are called to that self-giving love. But that's really what our baptism has done for us. That's what the Holy Spirit gives us. Even in this time that we're unable to receive the Lord in the Eucharist, we're not abandoned because the Spirit lives in us. It's a time where we are seeing that Spirit of love in action in new ways in our communities and around the world. You know, that water, that living water, is the love that's freely given by God that we can accept. And then when we do, you know, we're called to share it with those around us so that others will see Jesus as we see him in them. So let us come to see more clearly the life that we're called to live in God. And let's pray that the thirst that we have is not a thirst that's a human thirst, but a thirst for the Holy Spirit to overflow in us, to others, in that continued self-giving love now and in the future after this crisis is over. You know, as the old Christian folk song goes, they will know that we are Christians by our love.
United in love and in faith, let us profess that faith that connects us not only with God, but with all of our fellow believers. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, the gift of the Spirit of truth keeps us faithful to Jesus, who urges us to live in love, in communion with God, in union with the entire church. Then let us now join the risen Christ and pray to our Father for the needs of the church, of our community, and of the world.
For our Holy Mother Church, may she continue under the leadership of Pope Francis to proclaim the good news and the love of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, so that the people of the world may grow strong in their belief in Jesus Christ, Son of God, and born of the Virgin Mary.
we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of our country and the world, through the guidance of the Holy Spirit, may they work tirelessly for justice, peace, and constant respect for human life, born and unborn. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all students who are completing their study this year, may the Spirit of God help them to use the knowledge and skill they attain to serve God's people in truth, justice, and love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our confirmation candidates, as they are still waiting for public mass to receive the sacrament of confirmation, may the Spirit of truth strengthen their faith, increase their love, and endow them with all the virtues that make them worthy of practicing their Catholic faith in every aspect of their lives and witnessing Christ in every situation. We pray to the Lord. For all those in need of God's healing power, we remember Ann Butler, Ellen Driscoll, and all those in the prayer intentions of the weekly bulletin, that those suffering from coronavirus and other illness, may they be assisted by the risen Lord, and may those who heroically care for people with the coronavirus be protected from harm themselves and be strengthened by Jesus, the divine physician. We pray to the Lord. For those who have died, may they share in the glory and love of the risen Christ. We remember Anthony and Josephine and Frank Sacco, for whom this Mass is being offered. We pray to the Lord. For all of us gathered here, those who are praying with us online, and those who cannot attend Mass and receive Holy Communion today, may we always be grateful to Jesus, who humbled himself to show us the way to love one another as he loved us in communion with the Father, and may the Holy Spirit help to keep God's commandments. We pray to the Lord.
Father of love, may the sacrifice we are about to offer on this altar ascend with our prayers to you and bring upon us your blessing and your peace through Jesus Christ, your Son, with prayerful support of Mary, our Heavenly Mother, health of the sick, and of our perpetual help, we join in praying. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Of the Lamb. One.
God's holy people, we will dine in joy and peace, and our song will never cease, praising the Lamb upon the throne. One shout of joy we raise, one voice in exaltation, for in glory Christ is God, and in hope we now are drawn to one sacrifice of Christ. One sacrifice of Christ.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross. And by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the Lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Martha and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unending help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servants, Anthony, Josephine, and Frank, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who were united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall become like you for all the ages and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. at the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Like a child rests in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you. Like a child rests in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you. My God, I trust in you. You care for me, you give me peace. Like a child rests in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you. Like a child rests in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. In that beautiful homily, Deacon Joe talked about thirst, thirsting not just for ordinary water, but for truly life-giving water. And I know that you all thirst to be able to return to church and to return to the Eucharist, and we miss you, and we want to see you again. I'm so grateful to see at least a couple of people who are coming to church during the week to pray, or on various video conferencing meetings and gatherings we've had with Bible study and discovering Christ. But we long for you to be here again. As we thirst for all of these new beginnings this spring, because they will be new beginnings. Things will not be exactly as they were. We don't want to go back to January and February. That was winter time. We don't want to go backwards. We want to go forward, like the beautiful blossoms that Father Lambert set in front of our altars here at St. Mary and St. Martha. We want to go forward to wherever the Lord is leading us into new beginnings. And just as we anticipate announcements in our state this week about gradually, slowly beginning anew in various parts of our lives, we look forward to that day somewhere down the road, not right away, but down the road where we will be able to gather again around the altar together and to share this Eucharist and the community of the body of Christ with one another. I know that you are still connected by our baptism, our common baptism, and the Eucharist that you have received in the past, and please continue to pray for one another throughout our parishes and our Plainville and Wrentham communities. Hopefully, we'll have some announcements in the next week or so about at least reopening our parish offices in the near future, as the state and the archdiocese will give us guidance so that we can do so in a way that keeps us safe, especially the most vulnerable among us. As church, we have that responsibility to love and to be gentle and considerate of all of our people's needs. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.
I'd ask you to please stay afterwards. We'll have a wonderful opportunity for some more instrumental music that Jillian Corelli, our music director, will be providing. We'll continue that immediately following the Mass.
In Christ the Lord, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. White heights of love, white depths of peace. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. No guilt in life, no fear in death, this is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand till he returns.